This is TradeFlow News, bringing you relevant news and insights from around the world. TradeFlow News, enabling trade for SMEs and economies worldwide.
These are some of the key topics that we will be looking into in today's program.
First, let's take a look at the overnight headlines which are impacting the commodity markets.
Global oil demand will rise less than previously thought this year, led by weakness in China, the International Energy Agency, IEA, said on Thursday, bolstering its view that consumption is heading towards a plateau this decade. World demand will rise by 900,000 barrels per day, the advisor to industrialized countries said in a monthly report, down 70,000 barrels of oil per day or 7.2% from its previous forecast, which is at the lower end of the range the industry expects. There is a wide split in 2024 demand growth forecasts, owing to differences over China and the pace of the energy transition to cleaner fuels. The OPEC also cut its 2024 forecast this week, though its view remains far higher than the IEA's.
Russian exports of liquefied petroleum gas to China by rail jumped by almost 40% year-on-year in the January to August period to 184,000 metric tons, Reuters calculations based on industry sources and data showed on Thursday. Traders also said that Russian LPG rail supplies to China in July and August returned to monthly average levels of around 25,000 tons following a slump in May and June due to restrictions imposed by Russian railways to tackle bottlenecks. The sources said the main contributor to the overall exports has been the Ust-Kut gas processing plant controlled by the Irkutsk Oil Company. It boosted supplies by 60,000 tons in the first 8 months of the year.
Moving on to the top news in the energy sector.
India wants oil producers group OPEC and its allies to raise oil output as there are countries such as India where fuel demand is rising, the nation's oil secretary Pankaj Jain said on Thursday. The OPEC and allies, together called OPEC Plus, last week agreed to delay a planned oil output increase for October and November and said they could further pause or reverse the hikes if needed. India, the world's third biggest oil importer and consumer, imports over 80% of its oil needs from overseas. Fuel demand in India is rising and Jain said the country wanted OPEC and its allies, including Russia, to raise oil output.
Oil prices rose by more than 1% on Thursday to extend a rebound spurred by concern over Hurricane Francine's impact on U.S. output, though a gloomy demand outlook capped gains. Brent crude futures for November rose 94 cents, or 1.3%, to $71.55 a barrel by 12:05 GMT. U.S. crude futures for October were up $1, or 1.5%, at $68.31. A day earlier, both contracts had gained more than 2% as offshore platforms in the U.S. Gulf of Mexico were shut and coastal refinery operations were disrupted by Hurricane Francine's landfall in southern Louisiana. Next, we have the top news in metal markets. Copper prices jumped to their highest in nearly 2 weeks on Thursday on signs of firmer demand in top metals consumer China and the prospect of interest rate cuts. Three-month copper on the London Metal Exchange was up 1.6% to $9,238 a metric ton in official open outcry trading after touching its strongest since August 30 at $9,294.50. The market is looking perky. It looks like copper demand is potentially showing signs of recovery in China. I think that's the main driver for the market strength, said Ole Hansen, head of commodity strategy at Saxo Bank in Copenhagen, adding that stocks of both copper and aluminium have been shrinking of late.
Gold prices rose on Thursday on expectations of a U.S. Federal Reserve interest rate cut next week, while supply concerns from top producer Russia drove palladium above the key psychological level of $1,000. Spot gold was up 0.1% at $2,513.78 per ounce by 11:07 GMT, supported by the 21-day moving average at $2,505. U.S. consumer prices rose marginally in August, but underlying inflation signaled some stickiness, which could result in the Fed delivering a smaller 25 basis point cut at its meeting next week.
We will now look at the top news in the agricultural sector.
Strategy Grains lowered its forecast for soft wheat production in the European Union in 2024 to its lowest in 12 years, the second straight month the crop consultancy has cut the projection due to rain-hit harvests in France and Germany. The firm now estimates the EU's main cereal crop at 114.4 million metric tons, down 10% from last year and the lowest level since 2012, it said on Thursday in a monthly report. Strategy Grains had cut its EU soft wheat crop outlook by 5.8 million tons last month as harvest results confirmed severe effects from months of heavy rain in France and other parts of Western Europe.
That is all for today's news on commodity markets. Stay tuned to TradeFlow News as we continue to provide you with more updates. We also invite you to follow us on Twitter at TradeFlow News, which allows you to watch our program on your mobile device or desktop to receive information from there.